There we go.
I'd have to bust through that window.
I know there's an Uzi in here, I know. Alright, yeah, let's use it. I'll use all the ammo for the Uzi, then I'll come back for it and use my... Well, I'll swap it back for my handgun. So, in case you're getting bored of the jungle, we got a nice change of scenery for the fortress. And I love the jungle environment, like I said in my review. So, you know, it's a, I wasn't getting bored of the jungle environment, in case you were wondering. This bit is bullshit. See those, see that? Those bushes up there? They can, well, they are, it's just not fair because the enemies on the other side, like because of the way the AI has been designed, I mean, this is understandable, but, so yeah, it's understandable, but they shouldn't have put the bush and the wall in that exact spot. But the thing is, when the enemies are behind these bushes, they can shoot at you because of the way the AI has been designed, which is understandable. And of course, you obviously can't see them or at least get a good shot at them, get a good look at them. So it's pretty unfair, this bit, when the enemies wind up behind the bush. But thankfully, at this moment in time, the enemies are in a fair spot, let's say. They are in a location which I can see them. Oh, there's someone else. I can hear someone shooting, and it's not that guy. It's probably someone behind the bush. I guarantee there's someone's behind. Yeah, it is. See? You see that bullet? Yes, very fair. But it's fair for you to be able to shoot me from there. Nice one. There we go. I see him. Okay. I'll scavenge for some ammo. That's fine. I know you can climb up the wall to reach a treasure up there, which I am not getting per usual. I believe there's a treasure on one of these huts. I believe there's a treasure somewhere. Oh no, we don't want that, do we? We don't want that awful moss shotgun. And there's also a treasure on the other side of that rubble. I believe there's also a treasure over that rubble too. Our two guys come through the tunnel here. Oh, damn you. We got that mounted machine gun as well coming up. Nice one. Nice. Let's talk about those shotguns for a second. Didn't really have anything to say there. A little moment of silence. I didn't, couldn't think of anything to say. So let's break the silence and talk about the shotguns of the game. The shotguns in this game are awful, in my opinion. There's never really... I never had an incentive or felt inclined to use the shotguns at all in this game. By the way, to check out... Look, there. See? It's one of those classic video game tropes, which are just... Oh wow. One of those moments where one bullet ends your life. One single bullet while your health was moderately high. I hate those moments, especially when there's only one guy left in the area. A little surge of frustration coming out. Fucking bullshit, seriously. Oh, somebody killed themselves. Huh? Probably with a grenade. Or maybe they shot the explosive barrel. Maybe. One thing I'm planning on doing is a Let's Play of Metal Gear Solid. I'm not too sure about whether or not I should. The Metal Gear Solid series. Yes, I've completed every single one, except for Peace Walker and the NES games. But I would like... I'm considering doing a Let's Play of them, but the reason I'm considering not doing a Let's Play of them is because of the damn cutscenes. I mean, of course, obviously the... Wow. I wanted to do a brutal combat on him and it backfired. But the cutscenes for the Metal Gear Solid series is what is putting me off. That's what's putting me off from doing a Let's Play on them. And like the cutscenes. Like, don't get me wrong, the story is awesome, but I'm not sure if it's Let's Play material. I'm not sure if it would work too well for a Let's Play. Like, I know there have been people who have done Let's Plays of Metal Gear Solid before. And I'm pretty sure, I'm sure they're fine and dandy. Like, I've never watched one, but I don't know. I don't think I could really hold my own. I don't think I could provide entertaining enough commentary for a Metal Gear Solid Let's Play. I'm not too sure about that. Like, I am interested, or at least considering the idea of about doing a Let's Play of the Metal Gear Solid games. But whether or not I should actually do it, I'm not too sure. Let's take this guy out. He was probably the guy that killed me last time. At least he's dead. By the way, did you notice the guy up there? Explosive barrel. Shoot the explosive barrel to kill him. That's just one... No, don't die. Don't die. It's one of those classic video game tropes, ain't it? Where the enemies are... They think it's a really good idea to shoot at you while standing next to an explosive barrel. I mean, yeah, okay. It's just one of those video game tropes you've got to accept. And I guess it makes the gunfights a bit more interesting, I guess. Introduces a new element. Try and time it right so when they're next to the explosive barrel, shoot them, I guess. But that guy was just simply standing right next to it. I don't know. That one guy really stood out to me all the time, every time I complete the game. Let's stay quiet for the cutscene here. I don't really buy her being really stealthy either. How did she get through that castle without being spotted? How did she even get in there? I don't buy it.
Buka Pintu!
Ah, crap. Oh crap, what a catchphrase. Hate it.
It worked!
There he is!
Up there! Get on the gun!
Oh crap. Oh boy. Oh. At least he didn't say it that time. He said, oh boy, thank God. Let's waste my one-shot, one-kill gun ammo on these dudes as fast as possible. By here, of course, you got to mount the mountain machine gun. And the guy, that's one thing I've noticed, that I think they do it almost every time I complete this game. They go on the mountain machine gun and try and shoot you from it. Sometimes they turn the gun, like, to the right as much as possible in an attempt to shoot you. And of course, it doesn't reach you. That's just kind of, bad AI. It's a moment of pretty awful AI. It's not awful, not awful. It is awful. You can always tell when everyone's dead as well, when the music stops. This bit is really easy as well. There we go, guy on the mountain. Machine gun, shoot there. There we go, done. On your first playthrough, though, because you're not expecting it, that's kind of difficult because... Well, you obviously don't know it's coming up. And it might take you a while to figure out that there's explosive barrels right behind him. Again, what weirdly placed explosive barrels, and I'm not going to bother killing that guy behind me. Like, they obviously decided to put a mounted machine gun there, but why the explosive barrels? Like, you know, what were they thinking there? But yeah, that bit, might take a little while on your first playthrough, because you might not know there's explosive barrels right behind him. And also, because you're not expecting him to be there, you give him time to get on the mounted machine gun and start shooting at you, thus you need to take cover. But when you play this on multiple playthroughs, you know he's going to be there, so you have time to shoot the explosive barrels before you even begin shooting on the mounted machine gun. And where the hell did that guy come from? Oh, I bet the guy that came up behind me was the guy in the hallway. Because I let him live, he came down to kill me. Oh well. I'm pretty sure now he won't be coming back. That's close. I always try to take those guys up on the ledge first. I'm not sure if that actually makes a difference. I don't know, it seems like a wise strategy to me. Since we're low on primary ammo, we're going to use secondary ammo. I think he's the last guy, so... Obviously, we're going for the brutal takedown. And we're going to use this gun for now. That one thing about this area, which is kind of different, I guess, is... Well, it's flooded with water, the floor is. So when it's time to, like, try and collect ammo, like, scavenge for some ammo, it's kind of difficult to see where the guns are. that's it. You know, it's just a little bit more difficult to try and find out where the ammo is. So a lot of the time, like, I'm running around in circles in this room for a while after the gunfight is over trying to find ammo. But of course, the fact that the water has flooded the room makes it more difficult to see the guns in the water. So I end up giving up and just not getting as much ammo as I could have. Because like I said, the water makes it difficult to see. And this Uzi is really useful on these dudes. Like, the Uzi is really, it's a weapon which I just pick up to, like, waste all the ammo on. Like, I really only pick it up to just, like, waste all the ammo on. Like, I never keep it. I never keep it as for long because there's just not much of them throughout the game. Like, you can't get much ammo for the gun. So, like, obviously the most common weapon throughout the game is this handgun I've got right now. So, I feel more comfortable carrying that since you're going to constantly be finding ammo for it. Like, all the time, pretty much. And it's the same, like it's a different reason why I don't want to use the shotguns. The shotguns in this game don't seem to be much use to you because most of the gunfights take place in like let's say exteriors or big wide open spaces, like big wide open rooms or environments, so exteriors or courtyards and rooms and whatnot. Thus, they aren't really they're not much use because like obviously a shotgun is more used to in like a closed interior environment, like inside the building, claustrophobic hallways and like small rooms. That's what shotguns would be useful with you against. And obviously with the enemies, since there's lots of them, the shotgun isn't much use to you because while you're trying to get up to the enemies, while you're trying to get close to them, so the shotgun is effective, everyone else is shooting at you. So obviously the shotgun isn't much use. So I just feel as if the shotguns in every single Uncharted game, they're just not much use. They're not much use to you. So I just stick with like the other guns. I'm not quite sure exactly what you would, I don't know anything about guns, obviously. So I'm not sure what you would call an AK-47. Like the category that would fall in. I'm not sure what you would call it. An assault rifle, a heavy machine gun? I have no idea. Chapter 6 of, I think there's like 23 chapters. It's just 20 something. Early 20s.
Jesus.
And this is yet another gunfight which often gives me trouble.
Wait a minute. Now what's so important about that tower?